going to start a new chapter, that is on the springs. So in this first lecture, we will study the these are the course content. We will study for closed and open coil helical springs. They are subjected to axial load and axial torques, then leaf spring, then the flat springs, and their mathematical derivation. So today's lecture will be a introductory lecture. Of course, it will be covering the mathematical parts also, but we will be deriving the all the mathematical relations in the coming classes. So a helical spring, first of all, a helical spring. So basically, there are closed coil helical springs and the open coil helical spring. So first of all, what is a helical spring? So helical spring is a piece of wire which is coiled in the form of the helix. If the slope of the helix of the coil is small, so that the bending effects can be neglected, then the spring is called the closed coil helical spring. Okay, so you can see a closed coil helical spring is a piece of wire which is coiled in the form of helix. If the slope is small, then the bending effects are neglected, and this is known as a closed coil helical spring. So in this type of the springs, only the torsional shear stress are involved. Okay, only the torsional shear stresses are involved. If the slope of the helix of the coil is large, then both bending as well as the torsional shear stresses are introduced. So this is the difference between the closed coil helical spring with the small helix angle and with the large helix angle. So and that is a open one. So this type of the spring is called the open coil spring. So there is a closed coil spring in which the helix angle is small, and there is an open coil spring in which the helix angle is large. So if the helix angle is less than 5 degrees, then it is known as the closed coil helical spring. And if it is more than 5 degrees, then it is the open coil helical spring. So I think this difference is clear to you. On the other hand, a leaf spring is a beam of the uniform strength which is supported at the center and loaded at the ends. So it consists of number of the overleaves with the same width and the depth. So this you must have seen in the case of the automobile. So while going on the this portion of the springs, we will study the leaf spring. So basically, you can divide into the two broad categories, that is the helix spring and the leaf springs. And other third category is the spiral spring. So we will study all these springs. Now, before we go ahead, we have to understand some definitions. So first is the spring index. So it is denoted by C, and it is the ratio of the mean diameter of the coil to the diameter of the spring wire. Okay. Then second is the stiffness, which is defined as the load per unit deflection. So if W is the load, then deflection is say delta. So W by delta. Third is the torsional rigidity. So torsional rigidity or the torsional stiffness, like we have the flexural in the case of the bending, we have this EI as a flexural rigidity. Similarly here, in the case of the torsion, we have the GJ. So G is the modulus of rigidity and J is the polar moment of inertia. So it is known as the torsional stiffness or the torsional rigidity. The fourth definition is of helix angle. So it is just we have understood also, it is an angle which the axis of the spring of the wire makes with the horizontal line perpendicular to the axis of the spring. So this will be clear in the coming figures. So let us see, it is a closed coil helical spring which is under the axial load W. Okay, so this dm is the mean coil diameter. So it is from the center of the wire here and center of the wire here. So W is the axial load, dm is the mean coil diameter, d is the diameter of the spring wire. So this is the diameter with which the, now this diameter, if it is a circular one, it is d. Otherwise, this spring can also be made of some other cross section. It can be square, it can be rectangular also. Okay, so delta is the axial deflection, which is in the axial direction. G is the modulus of rigidity. Theta is the angular deflection. N is the number of the active coils. And tau is the maximum shear stress, which is introduced in this wire. Okay, so following assumptions are made for deriving the derivations. An element of the spring wire behaves essentially as a straight bar under the pure tension. So this we assume that there is a straight bar and it is under pure tension. The planes perpendicular to the bar axis do not wrap and distort during the deformation. As a result of this, the shearing stress will have a linear distribution on the radius. Suppose this is a radius of the wire and this is a center. So the shear stress variation will be the linear one, like this. We will understand this more clearly in the case of the derivation class. Third is the material of the wire is linear, homogeneous, isotropic, and obeys the Hooke's law. Another assumption is that direct shear stress and the curvature effects of the wire are neglected. So the torque will be equal to half W into dm. So if you see here, so torque will be half, this is dm by 2, so this is the distance. So torque acting here will be equal to the weight into the moment arm. So the shear stress by the torsion formula, so torsion formula, you know, T by J is equal to G theta upon L is equal to tau, that is the shear stress, by R. So R, it can be the small r or it can be the capital R, depending what you have taken. So the so you can, from here it will be T into R will be here, D by 2. So this D R is equal to D by 2, that is the diameter of the wire, divided by 2. So if you take from here, the tau is equal to T, that is the torque, into R, divided by J. If you put here R is equal to D by 2, so it is T into D by 2. So you see this expression has come. So here you put the value of T as half WDM2, and J, you know, J is nothing but pi by 32, okay, D4. So this you have put here. So you get the shear stress induced as tau is equal to, in the case of the open closed coil helical spring, which is subjected to a axial load, 8 dm upon pi d cube. D kat jayega hai, so it is pi d cube. So this is a expression of the shear stress you get, right? Now the length of wire is pi dn or 2 pi r. So pi D is the mean coil and N is the number of coils. So if you see the previous figure, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here there are 5 coils. So N is 5. Similarly, if there are more number of coils, so we'll multiply it by N. So that will give you the length of the wire, which acts as a shaft. So now you see from the torsion formula, T by J is equal to G theta upon L. So this theta is the angle of twist. So this is the angle of twist. Angle of twist. Angle of twist. So theta is equal to T into L upon GJ. So T you know, L you know from this formula. G is G and J you know, pi d4 upon 32. So this theta, it gives the angle of twist, right? Now the strain energy which is stored in the spring, it is half torque into theta. So the value of the torque you have put from this expression, theta you have just calculated. So U is equal to U. So U is equal to strain energy. So this is the strain energy which is stored in the case of the spring, closed coil spring. Now the actual deflection by the Castiglione's theorem. So Castiglione's theorem says that the derivative of the strain energy in the direction of the load. So load is W. So del U upon dW. So it is 8W d cube n upon gd power 4. So you see here. When you multiply this, so it will be 2 into 4, 8 d cube n upon gd power 4. So this will be the axial deflection. Axial deflection is this. Then stiffness. So as I told, the stiffness is load per unit deflection. So you inverse this, so it is gd power 4 upon this. So the stiffness of the spring is also calculated. So all these derivations are very simple. I think I need not to carry it again. So I'll put this video in the YouTube. From there you can make your notes. So when the effect of the direct shear stress and the curvature is also taken into account. Okay. So in that case, we introduce a factor Kw, which is known as the Wales factor. And the Wales factor is calculated by this. So this is a very important, it is a very important expression you have to remember. So where the C is the spring index. Spring index was nothing but the coil diameter, mean coil diameter dm, divided by the wire diameter. Right? So this you can put and you can correct the exact value of the shear stress. So this was all about the closed coil, which is subjected to the axial load. So you see, this was the W was axial load. The second case is the closed coil helical spring under the axial torque. Okay. So you see here, this is a coil. Other nomenclature is same. So here it is subjected to a couple M at the opposite ends. Okay. So this is DM. So M0 is the couple. So a closed coil helical spring under the axial torque or couple M0 is shown in the figure. The torque of the couple produces a bending stress in the coil. So this wind up angle in this case, which when we give the twist to the coil, it is wind up. So it is M0 into L upon EI. This you have to remember. Okay. The strain energy in this case will be half into couple into angle of rotation. So L will be pi dm into n, this you have known. So phi, you can keep the value of from here, m0. So this multiplied by m0. So m0 you have taken from here. m0 is equal to pi into I upon pi into EI upon L. Okay. So here what you did, you have just put this value of phi is equal to 64 m0, L की वैल्यू ये आ गई आपकी और E की वैल्यू ये आ गई एंड पाई की वैल्यू रख दी. सो I इज हाउ मच, I इज पाई डी फोर बिकॉज मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ द स्प्रिंग वायर अपॉन 64. सो इफ यू पुट हियर, इफ यू टेक हियर द फाई इज इक्वल टू एम जीरो एल जीरो यू हैव टेकन एल पाई डी एम इंटू एन ओके डिवाइडेड बाई ई एंड आई इज पाई डी फोर एंड दिस इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 64. Okay, this is n. So you will get the same expression that phi is equal to 64 m0 pi d n. So this, if you solve it, so you will get this expression. So in this expression from the strain energy, you put the value of phi from here. So you will get the strain energy u is equal to this. So this is the strain energy in the case of the coil which is subjected to the axial torque. So applying the Castiglione's theorem, so in this case if the angle of twist is beta, so that will be the derivative of the strain energy divided by the with respect to the couple. So del m zero, so if you differentiate it, so it will be 2 multiplied by 32, that will be 64 m0 dm into n upon e to the power 4. And we know that bending stress is equal to, how we have calculated, sigma b upon y is equal to m upon I. So m is m0 here and I, right? So if you calculate here, sigma b is equal to m0 into y will be d by 2 because it is maximum will be at the outer surface of the wire, because bending stress, if you see here, so this is a wire, so bending stress it will be like this maximum. Okay, so this is sigma b. So sigma b is this and I is pi d4 into 64. So ye kat jayega, this will be 32 and this 2 d will also go and it will make it d3. So you will get the bending stress as 32 m0 upon pi d4, right? So now the strain energy, which is here is a comparison, you can see when the axial load is there and when the axial torque is there. So when the axial load is there, so there we have taken an angle of twist as theta. This was the shear stress. This is the W he can calculate from here. So this will give us W is equal to tau into pi d cube upon this. So that means we have used the W here, okay, this, and we have used this expression 1. So we have put this tau and W. So this is the expression will reduce to this. So we can segregate this. So it is tau square upon 4g. So ye kat jayega because it will be 8 for the 64 divided by 4, okay, and this will be 4g, 4 into 4 16. So we have segregated this into this expression like this. So the first term, second term denotes the length and third term denotes the area. Okay, so this is area and this is length. So length into area is volume of the spring wire. So that means the strain energy is tau square upon 4g. So resilience, we know that the strain energy is stored per unit volume. So resilience of the spring is tau square upon g, and the maximum strain energy stored per unit volume is the proof resilience. So this is proof resilience. So this is in the case of the axial load. If we take the axial torque, then the strain energy is half into the applied couple into the angle of twist. So this angle of twist value we have taken from the previous expression, that is here, this one. So M0 again we have taken from here, M0 sigma b into pi d cube of 132. So this is the M0. Okay, so you put this value in this expression, this one. So rearrange this, that will be sigma b square upon 8e. So this will be 32 into 32, so 32 kat jayega, and this 32 we can write as 8 into 4. So this will be the L and this will be the A. Okay, so this is L and this is A. So length into A is volume of the spring. So this will be the volume, this volume. So sigma b square upon 80 into volume of spring. So you see it is sigma b square. So you see in the case of the axial load, the resilience is tau square upon 4g, whereas in the case of the axial torque, it is sigma b square upon 80. And in the case of the axial load, the proof resilience is tau square maximum value upon 4g, and the proof resilience is tau b square maximum upon 80. Right? So now, if the both the loads, axial load and the twisting moments, they are acting simultaneously. So they are not, applied in isolation. They are acting simultaneously. Then how to calculate? So let W is the axial load and M0 is that axial twisting moment. So this we know that T is equal to half W dm. The twisting moment in this case M0. So the total strain energy will be equal to, we have just calculated, tau square L upon 2GJ and M square L upon 2EI. So this we know, the strain energy in the case of the torsion, strain energy in the case of the bending. So this is strain energy SC in torsion, in torsion, and this is the strain energy in bending. Right? So this you put the value of T over here. So this will be the value upon 2GJ plus M square, ki jaga M0 ho jayega, M0 upon this. So if you solve this, so you take L, you put the value of L here. Okay, so put the value of L here as pi d mn. So that you take common and you try to make this expression from the above one. Okay, so this you will get final expression U as 32 dm n upon d small 4, like this. So applying the Castiglione's theorem in the case of the axial load, when we want to calculate the axial deflection, so when you differentiate this with respect to W, so this will be a constant, so this will be 0, so it will be 32 dm n upon pi d cube, and this will be 2 times, so that will be 4 here. So this, so that means the delta is equal to, it is the same expression which we have calculated earlier. In the case of the axial twist, So we will differentiate this with respect to M0. So in that case, this term will be constant. So it will be 0. So it will be 2 times M0 upon E into 32 dm upon n pi d cube. So this will be the beta. So this we have seen now the axial load and the twisting moments, if they act simultaneously, so we get the, we calculate the combined strain energy, and then we apply the Castiglione's theorem with respect to the load where we want to calculate the deflection. So I think we should stop today's lecture over here, and we'll take a second section, that is on the open coil helical spring. So that we'll take in the next class. So thank you very much for listening the lecture carefully. Thanks a lot.